Microsoft have recently invested over $19 billion into OpenAI, and it's actually not the first investment they've made with OpenAI. Back in 2019, Microsoft invested $1 billion into OpenAI and essentially got access to the language tech for own uses for its Azure cloud customers. Now, things are coming to life with Microsoft, and they're bringing it into their product. And what they're calling a third phase of the long-term partnership that they have with OpenAI. Now, if you don't know, Microsoft 365 offers a range of different tools. And of course, a lot of the technologies in there are pretty advanced already, but combining with OpenAI can be really, really interesting. Now, I would want to talk about a few of the ways that I think this is going to play out, and more talk about what this looks like in a 3-year window. So first of all, we can't ignore the elephant in the room. Now, that's not Evernote, that is Google. Google have a similar workspace experience to Microsoft, offering a cloud experience, but also a combination of productivity software that they can use at work, as well as pretty robust email experience too. Now, in some extents, Google are doing okay job. They have a large audience, but I definitely think that this is going to change things. Google is well known in the AI space at the moment to be rapidly underperforming when it comes to the available AI powered technology and features. And it's something that even you can tell in their products and experience is still lacking. But I can imagine Google have their own AI system that they're planning and working on and probably aiming to release as humanly fast as possible to all of their enterprise and personal customers. So in this sense, Microsoft have made a real roll of the dice, but a very calculated roll of the dice by bringing in this technology. Now, the way that I sort of see this is like a chassis and an engine. I talked about this a few years ago. I always think of this sort of relationship as OpenAI is the engine behind this, and Microsoft and their 365 platform is essentially the chassis that goes over the top. Both work in tandem, but the power truly comes from the AI software. Obviously, Microsoft have a lot of a bigger engine, and this is almost a bolt-on at the moment, but this is a really interesting partnership when they're trying to take on the likes of Google. I think it's definitely going to progress them very far forward. Now, let's talk about the Microsoft Teams premium feature. A lot of people are typically getting this wrong at the moment, posting that Microsoft Teams have introduced the OpenAI feature pretty fast. But Microsoft Teams essentially had the premium ready in October 2022 with an AI system built themselves that would basically transcribe meeting notes, extract tasks, be able to collaborate with other applications. So they already offered that service. But Microsoft essentially weaved this OpenAI system in order to cut costs and add better production value. Obviously, we all know that the OpenAI system is a lot more advanced and really does bring together a lot of stuff. So they're including this GPT 3.5, I believe it is, into the Teams experience, allowing you to do much more effective, intelligent recap. You can actually find a video that we've done about how this actually operates. It's pretty much the same core experience, just with a different engine or AI system here. So they've interestingly already introduced this experience, which is fast and rapid development. So they've switched out that, and they've also introduced a way to build applications in Azure using code apps as well, which is pretty fast and pretty rapid in development. Now, to be honest, it's something that Microsoft are just going to continue to evolve. They're planning to Bing with faster ChatGPT in coming weeks, and with GPT-4, I'm sure that this will advance things further. However, I do think Microsoft are sort of very early stages with this technology, and I do have a few thoughts on where I think it potentially could go. So at the moment, there's a service that Microsoft haven't actually released yet, and it's called Microsoft Loop. If you want a full sort of overview of what Loop does, you can find it in our videos. But I've been following Microsoft Loop, well, it was previously called Fluid Framework, for a few years now, and I've quite liked how that technology works. Now, I do believe that Microsoft Loop will almost become the glue between the technologies, allowing you to do, say, Outlook in Teams or PowerPoint in Word, you know, really taking the technology of being able to do different stuff in different areas and be able to collaborate. But now with the introduction and investment in OpenAI, I think that Microsoft Loop has the potential to even pivot towards something even brighter and even more interesting. Now, if you've got a technology that is can be weaved across services and weaved to be built across services, that can be much more exciting. And I almost think that Microsoft Loop could be the Zapier for Microsoft within their applications. Now, hear me out. Microsoft Loop allows you to create different tools whilst being in another tool. So for example, if you're in Teams, you will in the future be able to collaborate on an Excel document and do that within that window. Now imagine if I was able to just type in create a Excel document with everything I'm chatting about. Loop could potentially be the glue to do that and allow you to continue collaborating on that document. So that's my prediction. Obviously, I'm being very futuristic about this. And to be honest, I think it's probably more in a 3-year window that something like this would be introduced. But I have a feeling that could actually be a better window to view the lens of Microsoft Loop in the system. Microsoft Loop is almost like a glue, an adhesive between all of the different web and mobile services that they offer. And being able to optimize glue like that would be very cool. Like being able to use it with ease and being able to create stuff. And the only limitation being your creativity to producing the work, it could be very interesting. And also, it really lends itself to the decision-making phase that we'll probably go through with AI, where it's just essentially get the AI to do everything for you. You still check, you still decision-make about the quality of the result. And Microsoft Loop could potentially be that for all of these experiences and bringing them together. This is a very far-fetched opinion, but I definitely think that's where Microsoft will be going. But bringing it back down to the surface, this investment in OpenAI, $19 billion, and the third phase of it, which not many people know, is definitely something to look out for. I think that the future of Microsoft is very bright with this investment. And I think that investing and really getting in there early will almost be looked at like a cheap investment because of how progressive this technology will go. And being in sort of bed per se, or being in sort of the back pockets of OpenAI, really gives them opportunity to test these technologies that are potentially evolving and coming out, and actually releasing your enterprise software with them before anybody else, which is pretty awesome. So Google's got to do a lot of catching up. Microsoft has some huge potential with this new investment, and I'm really interested in how this is going to play out in the coming months and the coming years. So thank you very much for listening along. If you enjoyed this and you've stayed this far, it'd be great to have you as a subscriber. And if you want to check out Tool Finder, which will help you find any productivity tool, you can find that linked below. But I would love to hear your opinion in the comments below. So if you do want to share about where you think Microsoft is going, this is a great opportunity to share that in the comments below. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you all very soon. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here. And also you can subscribe to as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Tool Finder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.